Hello to everyone, I am Marianna Fedeli, a PhD student and a member of the Processing and Service Laboratory of the University of Camerino in Italy. Today I will show you our work called Flower, an approach to IoT support and application development. First of all, I will introduce the main topics of this presentation, the Internet of Things, future models and flow-based programming. Then I explain our Flora approach in detail using a smart campus scenario, and in the end I draw some conclusion. Let's start with a brief introduction to the Internet of Things. The Internet of Things represents all the interconnected devices and resources capable of sensing and communicating with each other to create services with or without human intervention. The development of IoT applications that interconnects these devices and services is a complex activity that requires an high investment of resources. One of the main problems is the interconnection between heterogeneous devices and different communication protocols. Often, the application software code of these devices and services is proprietary. Does not help the interoperability and the customization of the IoT application. All of these problems result in high cost and time of software application development and a low usability of the code. More in general, there is a lack of standard methodology to support the IoT application development that could resolve all the problems mentioned above. For these reasons, we propose a novel approach based on model-driven engineering methodology. The model-driven methodology allows to foster software productivity and reduce development time and costs. This methodology enables the automatic generation of high-quality code based on model system requirements. In particular, to model the system requirements, we decide to use feature models, that is a model under the software product line paradigm. This model is commonly used in IoT domains to represent all the variability and commonality features that a family of systems or devices can have, and is usually represented in a tree form. From a configuration of future model, it is possible to generate document, models, or chunk of code to define a software application. In the IoT domain, is used to modeling small to medium scenarios to highlight the system requirements. To develop an IoT application, our approach uses the flow-based programming paradigm, that is a type of data flow programming where the central pillar is the data reception, manipulation, and sending. A flow-based programming application is composed of a sort of isolated black box software processes. And each process has a specific behavior and exchanges data using external connection. For this reason, this type of paradigm is commonly used in IoT scenarios with graphical tools that allow the easy interconnection between heterogeneous devices and services to develop IoT applications. More specifically, our approach allows the automatic development of IoT applications starting from the feature model design. In particular, we divide the approach into two main phases, the modeling and the development phases. For each phase, we have the actors of that domain that will follow some steps and produce artifacts. These artifacts will be saved in a future model repository and databases. For the correct usage of the approach, at the first step, we recommend using FutureIDE, an Eclipse plugin, to design the future model and verify its validity. To cover the usage of all the remaining steps of the approach, we developed a Flower core component, and inside we imported a Node-RED tool to run the application. The Flower core component is a lightweight component built with JavaScript and Electron framework and can be installed on gateways and the cloud servers. This component allows using the future models as a backbone for the IoT systems and devices configuration. It allows graphically configuring IoT scenarios starting from an initial future model to generate an IoT application automatically. And more information about the approach and the components are available on our website. To explain in detail the flower approach, I will use a smart campus scenario. In our example scenario, the university wants to standardize the IT systems that have in some departments to have a clear vision about the entire campus and build other IoT systems in new departments. I assume that all the departments are equipped with basic intelligence systems such as temperature and light management. In addition, each department has a particular necessity based on the department functionality and needs specific IoT devices. So, in the first step of our approach, we have the modeling and the IoT experts in charge to model the entire scenario using the future models. As you can see from the image, we represent the whole Smart Campus domain at the root point of the model. Then, at the second level, we express all the functionality that the scenarios can have. To have a better vision of it, I highlight in yellow all the mandatory functionalities for all the department must have. In this case, the temperature and the light management. While in blue, I highlight the optional features that can be selected to develop a specific department IoT system. Then, for each functionality, you can insert all the devices that this functionality can have, dividing between sensors and actuators. In addition, the experts have to define a future model that can express all the properties that a device can have. In this case, we represent the devices mainly with the communication protocol they use to communicate with the system, the type of data they send, and what they want to receive. In our Flower Core component, we provide some future models templates to use for modeling the system. Once designed the models for the IoT system and devices for the entire scenario, the Flower Core component will input the models, elaborate them, and allow the graphical configuration of each department. The component can verify the validity of the configuration according to the initial model. For example, suppose that I decide to exclude a mandatory functionality such as the temperature management from my configuration. The component will show an error because my configuration doesn't comply with the model's rules. So the experts configure the IoT system for each department and decide which devices they want to include in it. Then they need to insert all the specific information about the devices, the communication protocol, and others, according to the future model previously imported. After the experts have configured all the departments, the IoT application developer has access to the Smart Campus configurations and can select for which department and which functionality insert to create an application. For example, the developer can have the necessity to build an application only for the chemistry department to control and manage the temperature of that system. So after selecting the configuration, the Flower Core component will translate the chosen functionalities in code that can run into the Node-RED tool that we have incorporated in our component. The translations allow the automatic generation of an IoT application in the form of a process flow. And thanks to the specific information previously inserted, as you can see in the figure, the application can communicate directly with the devices, taking input to their data, elaborate and graphically show them using a dashboard. Then, the application developer can decide to expand the generated template to add some complex operations onto the data. The developed application can be deployed in a gateway as well as in the cloud, according to the specific necessity of the scenario. At the actual state of the work, our approach can reduce the complexity of developing IoT applications using a model-driven engineering methodology. In addition, our approach increases the separation of concerns because the developer can be unaware of the technical specification of the IoT systems and can put their effort into developing the application's logic. Moreover, thanks to the Flow Worker component, we can support the entire model-to-code transformation, providing an easy-to-use interface for the configuration and the automatic generation of templates for the development. In a future state of our work, we want to validate the entire approach involving domain experts in some departments of our university, and we want to increase the amount of automatically generated templates to support more complex operations for IoT applications. All the specific information about the Flower approach are available on our website, and thank you for your attention.